ये गाना कैसे कैसे यू नो हाउ डिड यू प्लान दिस हाउ डिड दिस हैपन?
एक्चुअली इनिशियली द प्लान वॉज कि वी शुड मेक अ गुड सॉन्ग एंड अप्रोच डिफरेंट प्रोड्यूसर्स. सो आई मेड अ टीम एंड इज मेड अ सॉन्ग एंड स्टार्टेड अप्रोचिंग डिफरेंट प्रोड्यूसर्स. एंड आई फाउंड माई डायरेक्टर फैजल मियाँ फोटो वाले एंड देन ही डिसाइडेड टू शूट मी फॉर दिस. And then after shooting, the video went to T-Series and they also liked it and so they released it on the channel.
So, you know, being a singer, composer, lyricist, it's such a big responsibility, and being your debut, I mean, weren't you nervous?
Actually, being a music director and lyricist wasn't my initial plan. My plan was to be a singer. But since when I started learning singing, then I found that, okay, phir music kaun banayega? सो देन आई स्टार्टेड लर्निंग मेकिंग हाउ टू मेक म्यूजिक एंड देन फिर जब मैंने म्यूजिक बनाना शुरू किया तो फिर आई केम अक्रॉस दिस क्वेश्चन कि अरे लिरिक्स कौन लिखेगा. आई डिडंट हैव अ बिग फ्रेंड सर्कल हु कैन यू नो फाइन लिरिसिस. सो आई स्टार्टेड लर्निंग टू राइट लिरिक्स एज वेल. सो दैट्स हाउ इट हैपेंड.
Singer to singer now, you know, being a musician and so which aspect of music making are you liking the most?
It's really very hard to pick. When I dub songs, I love being a singer. When I'm making music, then I want to be a music director. Lyricist, I'm not very sure, but I also like writing lyrics as well.
So, you know, there's always a role model when you come to singing. As you said, I mean, singing is your major thrust that you would work upon. So, ek koi aapka role model ki mujhe, I love this kind of singing in this style. Because, you know, your singing is very different, which I figured.
Yeah. I have two inspirations in Bollywood. One is Pritam Chakraborty and second is Arijit Singh. So those are my inspiration and I have learned a lot by listening to their music, their work. Actually learn more from them than any music school or college that I attended.
So what's the experience being even featuring in a song, you know?
Actually, I was very, very reluctant. I was not going to be on the screen, and my director literally forced me into like, "Tumhare career ke liye acha hoga." So, I did it. It was a hell of a task. I only know how tough was it for me. So yeah.
I mean, obviously, we would want to hear the song live from you now.
Sure. हाँ पास है दिल के धागों में है जब लिखी थी जुदाई फिर क्या रुलाई सौंधे पल मिस्र कल लौटेंगे लौटेंगे बंजारा मेरा सफर मिलता कहाँ मुझको घर भीड़ों में खो गया खुद में ही ढल गया गया ओ
Which camera do I look into?
Center.
Okay.
So what's your journey been like? How did you bag the role in the debut?
Honestly, it's a very funny story. I met Faisal at Kirti's birthday party and I was very talkative that night and he was like, you know, there's something I saw in you and I was like, I want this girl to be in my video. So literally that is how I got the role and yeah, so it just worked out.
So this was something that you planned?
No, it's not something, but it's something I've always wanted to do. I've always wanted to do different kinds of things. I don't like doing anything that is monotonous. I like doing like, you know, I've done youth shows, I've done short films, I've done, now I'm doing my first film, I've done serials, I'm a VJ also, so I always want to branch out and like try different things, so this was like the best decision ever, I loved it, it was a lot of fun.
So, I mean, there's a lot of responsibility also, because your first song, you've got to express, cry, laugh, and you know, all the emotions were there, so how was the whole experience, were you nervous, how did it happen?
Honestly, it just happened. It was like we were passing this one place and we saw, you know, Faisal saw this one place and he saw that, you know, this would be such a killer place to shoot. So it was just spontaneous. And I think it just worked out. All of us, like our energies, our vibes gelled so well together that it just came out so well. And we all, I don't know, we made magic happen. It was awesome.
So what is that one incident that you want to share with everybody while shooting the song?
The one instance was when there was this one scene where I had to walk on the beach and cry and like just lose it. I didn't care about hair, I didn't care about makeup. I was just like in my own zone, lost it completely. And that's when Faisal came up to me and he was like, "You are a damn good actor." That was like the best moment ever. That is what you've always wanted. That is what I work for. That is what you want to hear. So that was the best moment ever.
And what are your future plans now?
Bollywood. It's happening soon.
Do you want to talk about the film that you're doing?
So I'm doing this film with this new production house called Divya Films Creatives. Vikram Sandhu is the producer. Simran Sandhu is his wife. So he's the director. She's the producer. And I'm also Vaishali and Kabir, friends of mine. And Vaishali was in Sasural Simar Ka with me. She's also in this movie. We shot our first schedule in Spain in this place called Valladolid. And it was a lot of fun. We met the mayor. We did a lot of fun stuff there. We shot like these really cool, I can't talk about it, but yeah, it was lots of fun.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So we want to know something about the singer and the composer, you know, since you featured in the song, what's been your experience? I'm asking you.
Me? Oh, okay. He, firstly, you guys need to know that he's like such a nice guy and he's so sweet and he'd just be like, "Oh, how did you do that? And how did that happen? Oh, but how did your tears just come out?" Like, he was so cute. He's so like, so innocent and he's a really nice guy and his voice is just, you know how it sounds there, you know, people do usually think that, you know, people have done like stuff to his voice. You guys heard him live. Like, he sounds like that in reality. He's really good.
And what do you have to say about your experience with her?
I really got goosebumps when I saw her acting and I told her then and there, ki, how did you cry on spot? I felt like, I have never been to an acting, like on a set, on, and I have never watched these acting things. But there, then when I saw her acting, she is basically the soul of Banjara Safar.
Aww, so sweet.
Thanks. The song, it looks lovely, Banjara Safar. How did the
Safar
start and what is it all about?
Actually, he's a surprise package for me. And the moment I met him for the first time, I remember I asked him, what all you have, I want to hear it. And I heard his song, Banjara Safar. I couldn't believe it. I asked him to stop in between and I said, is it you actually? You sung this song because this is a very new kind of a music, the very new kind of a singing. So I got very impressed. And he's very young. He's just, I think he's 20, 21.
19.
Oh, sorry. Okay, he's 19. I forgot. I think I'm aging. So I keep forgetting things. So I was very surprised and I said, okay, fine. Then I called up his father and I said, I really want to make this video. And then we chose Goa that we will, then he wanted to have some nice story in it. So he had that story and Bucket List Films, the company which I own, my full team supported me and then we did it and that's how this, and T-Series also, I mean, million thanks to T-Series that gave an opportunity to him for a kind of a platform where he can, you know, flourish and achieve what you want.
So what was the concept, Faisal, when you heard the song? You know, obviously it's always difficult to pick up when it comes to, you know, heartbreak and, you know, how did you plan all that?
See, heartbreak is very easily, I mean, heartbreak is easily available in the market these days. So pick up a story, a heartbreak story. See, I won't say it's a new thing which I did it. I came across with my very close friend. She actually had a same kind of a story in real life, that she conceived a child, and then, you know, the youngsters, they don't believe in the marriage institution. They believe in live-in and all these things. And when this thing comes right in front of their face, they don't know how to cope up with it. So so how they react on such things. So I got an idea from that story, and I said, okay, fine, let's capitalize on that particular ground and let's do it. So that's how it happens.
Anything you would want to start the journey?
The best part of this video is all these three. Okay, say I'm not available. Okay, so the best part of this, the full journey, is the number one is Ayan, then Krizan, Gaurav Bajaj. All three of them performed amazing. I mean, I, being a director, I think I had nothing to say when I was shooting with them, because they actually got into the skin of the character. I think they've gone through the depression for 2-3 days, so they performed very well, and I had a really, really great time, because for a director, if you get an actor like these, I mean, you're 75% of your battle is done. So that's it, and many congratulations to Ayan, Krizan, and Gaurav. My full team, they are not here because they're shooting somewhere. Rishabh, Ujwal, Dheeraj, Prashant, they are the one who did fabulous job. Shadab Rain, the music,
master engineer.
So overall, it's a team effort. Thank you, Ghazala, for supporting the main bucket list owner. So that's it.
Future plans, what's next?
We are making a couple of more videos with Ayan, and we are working with Krizan again, because but this is going to be different, because this time I'll not make her, you know, cry or something like that. She will be dancing, but she's a fabulous dancer as well. So I want to give her a very bubbly kind of a role. So that's what I'm going to discuss in a couple of days, and we might be shooting in South Africa maybe. So this is the future plan what I have.
Thank you.
Thank you.